Sloan's Liniment, your faithful friend when muscles ache and pain, presents Gangbusters.
Calling the police, calling the G-men, calling all Americans to war on the underworld.
Gangbusters brought to you by the makers of Sloan's Liniment. With the cooperation of leading law enforcement officials of the United States, Gangbusters presents facts in the relentless war of the police on the underworld. Authentic case histories that show the never-ending activity of the police in their work of protecting our citizens. America's crusade against crime. Ladies and gentlemen, Colonel H. Norman Schwarzkopf, our regular interviewer, is now serving with the United States Army. However, the colonel is continuing his supervisory duties on Gangbusters by proxy. In a moment, we'll be ready for our proxy interview between Colonel Schwarzkopf and Chief of Police J.P. Coffey of Valdez, North Carolina, who will relate the facts in the case of the ape bandit, the college athlete who turned killer. But first, friends, there are three important qualities which have made Sloan's Liniment the world's best-known liniment for muscular aches and pains. Sloan's brings quick relief. Sloan's is the pad-on liniment. No rubbing or massaging is needed. And Sloan's eases pain, whether it's caused by overexertion, accident, or cold weather. Next time your muscles seem to be tied in knots, next time your back or your shoulder is stiff and sore, try patting on Sloan's Liniment. It takes but a second, and almost instantly, you can feel that comforting warmth ease away the pain. If you haven't a bottle on the medicine shelf right now, it's time you made a mental note to ask your druggist for a handy bottle of Sloan's, the quick-acting liniment. Now for our proxy interview between Colonel Schwarzkopf and Chief of Police J.P. Coffey of Valdez, North Carolina. Picture our setting as a special office turned over to the colonel by Commissioner Louis J. Valentine of the New York City Police. Colonel Schwarzkopf.
Chief Coffey, this case of Dwight Beard certainly has many unusual angles. As I recall, Beard had a powerful physique and was a star college athlete. His cunning brain used this to make incredible escapes.
That's right, Colonel. After looting a house, Beard would leap from an upper-story window to a nearby tree, swing himself to the ground, and then disappear. But Beard was soon apprehended. And the court, believing him sincerely repentant, placed him on probation, never realizing that Beard was already scheming new criminal activities.
And you knew I'd never go to jail. And you, if I put on a good crying act, the court would think I was repentant. They caught me once, but they'll never get me again. I have a new plan. All I need is money, and I'm getting that money tonight.
It was on the night of February 18th, 1932, in the little town of Valdez, North Carolina, that Beard went after this money. There, Beard and another man waited for the return of the local storekeeper.
Are you sure this storekeeper will have the money on him tonight, Beard?
I know he will. I also know he'll come up this path to his house.
Where can we hide?
This tree.
Why, you're crazy, Beard. We can't both hide back of this tree.
We won't be back of it. We'll be up it.
What?
Go on, climb.
Okay, Beard, if you say so. Come on.
You got it?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, do you think this branch will hold both of us?
Sure.
There. Now when our friend passes under the tree, we'll drop down and grab him.
Yeah, that's a good idea, but what if...
Shh. Someone's coming.
It's the storekeeper.
Get ready.
I'm set.
Drop.
Oh, who are you?
No noise. Hand over that money.
No, no, I won't.
Quiet, you. It's in that satchel, pal. Grab it.
I got it.
No, no, no. Help. Hey, give me my money.
I said
give me
quiet.
Beard, you killed him.
In this brutal manner did Dwight Beard commit his first murder, Colonel. Immediately, printing presses roared as thousands of police circulars were sent to all nearby police departments.
To all police chiefs, urgent, wanted for murder, Dwight Beard, 23, 175 pounds, 5 feet 11 inches, fair complexion, athletic build, reward for his arrest and conviction. Notify J.P. Coffey, Chief of Police, Valdez, North Carolina.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.